I get to meet mental clinic, meet the work, meet for the first time the reality of their work in Hong Kong, then in Basel. Then we spoke more. We spoke several times more like this. Then I came to Istanbul and I discovered the reality of their field and of their vocabulary, and which I describe a little bit like a disco ball, which is not just one thing but a lot of different facets which all goes together. And I found absolutely amazing the way they approach art, the way they behave, the way they produce things. And their world was really, for me, really interesting. So we discussed immediately the idea of making an exhibition that would put together all their vocabulary together, because many people have difficulty to understand how one work is linked with the other. So we wanted to make a mental clinic. We decided to show somehow 10 years of their work, a survey of production of 10 years of their work, collaboration between Yasmin and Biol, but not as a retrospective. This exhibition is not at all a scientific one, where one year by year you follow the development of the work, but everything is mixed together. Everything is like in reality mixed together. So it's much more an introspective, more diving into their reality than showing retrospectively in a very clinical way their work. First, I was very interested by the generic name of this collaboration, these two artists existing below this world, these two worlds, mental clinic. And it reminds me some of my the artist I was working in the 80s, like General Idea, Information Fiction Publicity, Group Material. Many of those artists who were acting as a factory or reacting to the generation of egotistic artists, the heroes of the 80s, for example. And we live somehow another generation of artists who are existing more and more and advertise somehow with their name as a brand. And Mental Clinic is a kind of a manifesto in itself. With some values saying that, of course, art is about mental, but it's a clinic as well, a clinic as a factory, but as well, we are a little mad. We are, there is this sense of these two worlds together, mental and clinic, which is at the same time comfortable and uncomfortable. Do I want to be in a mental clinic or do I refuse? Do I accept my difference with the other? How do I live with these issues that all normally point you out as someone strange? And somehow they are saying that the artists are very different in our society. They are the only one able to say I in a world where we live in collectivity, where the we is what characterizes our society. So this is this idea of this possibility of stating things and existing, and as well a kind of generic world under which they can invite other people, kind of a laboratory or a platform of dialogue, of exchanges, of production, which is kind of a freer form than just one name where everybody is working for one persona and pushing this persona somewhere else. So I found this territory very interesting and very fascinating, the way they deal with a lot of irony, a lot of very seriousness at the same time. There is always these two parts in their work, from one to the other, that you can see as well in some of the words they put together, like this title of the exhibition, which is that's fucking awesome, or what I have in front of myself now, which is she's awfully beautiful, this kind of oxymoron, these two antagonist, contradictory words together, which creates another meaning, which is questioning, of course, many things. So I like this idea of, as I often say about their work, that it has a kind of the smell of bubble, of or something like a champagne glass, and at the same time it has something very raw, very tough, very rigid, and almost aggressive. So it's from one to the other one. Which one should I take? Which one should I consider? And for me, it's exactly how often artworks are seen. There is many words that you don't know how to handle with. Is it serious? Is it unserious? Is it shaking me? It doesn't make any emotion, or it creates anything. So I think it's really dealing with issues of art. I was really happy to meet Yasmin and Biro, because they are two charismatic persona, and I have to say very unique artists in the way they generate their vocabulary, their world, the way they behave, and the way they share things with others, and the way they work. And I think they have a fantastic possible development in the next decade. Well, I'm very happy and that gallerist was excited to produce this pop-up exhibition in Istanbul. It's quite rare that galleries, commercial galleries, are eager to make shows outside of their traditional spaces. So they did a great job, and they're very, very amazingly supportive to those artists. So it's fantastic.